I think with this premise, let us go a little more deeper in terms of our understanding of this concept. So let me take you through some more sort of expressions. Which can make it even clearer for us as to what is this law of conservation of divinity. The best place to lay our hands is chapter 7 of Bhagavad Gita. Onwards, actually I would say 7 onwards, I'll come to it later. But the best thing is to start from chapter 7, which has a very rich description. Look at here. मत्तपरतरं न अन्यत् किञ्चिदस्ति धनंजय मयि सर्वमिदं प्रोक्तं सूत्रे मणिगणा इव. That's the first shloka I want you to look at, the seventh shloka in chapter 7. In fact, it is my understanding that, as many of you might know, Bhagavad Gita is made of three triplets. The first triplet, 6 chapters, second triplet, 6 chapters, and third triplet, 6 chapters. The way I have understood Bhagavad Gita, in each of these triplets, there is only one shloka that summarizes the entire triplet. The remaining shlokas in all the adhyayas in that triplet explains only that shloka. So if you ask me what is the second triplet, the second triplet is only this shloka. Mattaparataram na anyat kinchidasti dhananjaya mayi sarvamidam protam sutre manigana iva. Arjuna, Krishna is saying, hey Arjuna, mattaha parataram, there is nothing other than me, na anyat kinchi asti dhananjaya, there's not even a speck of dust other than me. So categorically Krishna says here, matta parataram na anyat kinchit asti dhananjaya. Then he says, mayi, in me, sarvamidam protam, all that you see is actually in me only. And how it is? Sutre manigana iva. Just like, you know, you take a very long thread and, you know, you put the red color bead, then a green color bead, yellow color bead, a magenta color bead, a square bead, a round bead, a diamond stone. You put whatever you want to put. They are all on that thread. So like that, Krishna very distinctly brought in this concept of law of conservation of divinity in this shloka, and the entire triplet starting from chapter 7 up to 12th chapter, which is the end of the second triplet, this idea was so beautifully explained in detail. Some you see here itself, look at here. Rasoham apsu kaunteya prabhasmi sashi suryayo प्रणव सर्ववेदेषु शब्दः के पौरुषं नृषु रसः अहम् अप्सु. He says, you take water. Water means any liquid. Any liquid you take, the sapidity, that liquidness which creates it to flow, liquid's properties to flow, that is because of its sapidity. He says, you see me there. So I am there. He says, rasaha aham apsu kaunteya prabha asmi sashi suryayoho. You take moon and sun and all luminaries in the world, the light that you see is the divinity. I am that light. Prabha asmi sashi suryayoho pranavaha sarva vedeshu. Of all the entire gamut of the Vedic repository, I am that pranava, om, I am that. That is what he is expressing there in so many ways. Shabdaha ke paurusham rishu. I am the sound that you see in the ether. And I am, if you see very, you know, valiant people, that strength and valor that they show is me. That is the divinity. Bijam mam sarva bhutanam vidhi he partha sanatanam. Time immemorial, I am the seed. That is why nobody knows when did this jackfruit started. Nobody knows when did this tea plant started. I mean, they say in 1728, one Englishman brought a what he brought from somewhere. In India, they say in 1728, an Englishman brought a tea herb and put it in Assam and all that story they say. My question is, where did he get from? When was the first tea plant started? When was the first jack tree started? You don't have an answer for it. That's why he says, I am beetam, bijam mam sarvabhutanam viddhi partha sanatanam. Buddhihi buddhimatam asmi. When there are intelligent people, please see that their intelligence is divinity. They may have a lot of, some of them may have an ahankar. That's a different story. The divinity expresses as brilliance. That spark, that brilliance that you see is divinity. So, buddhihi buddhimatam asmi, tejaha tejasvinamaham. When there is a, you know, great person, that greatness is the divinity. I will give you a very simple example for this. See, when Swami Vivekananda went to Chicago Parliament of Religions, we know all that story. So, you know, I keep reading it, I keep reflecting, I keep thinking about it again and again, because there is this one statement which makes a little sense to you if you just look at the statement. It says, Swami Vivekananda rose and he said, my dear brothers and sisters of America, they were all taken aback. And the rest followed. Like this, I've read. People have said, I have read. If I go somewhere and say, my dear brothers and sisters, they may throw stones at me. They may look at me like this. What I'm saying is, Swami Vivekananda saying, the tejas that Swami Vivekananda brought in is divinity. It's only a vehicle to radiate that divinity. So that's what he says. Tejas, tejas vinamaham, balam balavatam chaham. When people have a lot of strength, the strength is mine. People, you know, mistakenly think it is theirs. And the day people think I have the tejas, I have the strength, I have the buddhi and so on, that is called ahankar. They are on their way out. They are on a path of self-destruction, that they fail to understand that they have been lucky enough for the divinity to radiate through them. That is what this means. Balam balavatam chaham kamaraga vivarchitam. Right? That then dharma avruddha bhuteshu kamosmi. That your kama must be dharma avruddha. It should not vitiate dharma. Whenever such kind of kamas are there, see divinity. I mean, the whole chapter 7 onwards up to chapter 12, it's full of this actually. I may not have time to get into all these, you know, because then we will only end up doing this. I just wanted to first take these definitions to tell you that this is what is law of conservation of divinity in action. Look at this beautiful shloka from Manisha Panchakam, one of the greatest works of Swami Shankaracharya, Adi Shankaracharya. जाग्रत स्वप्न सुषुप्तिषु स्फुटतरा या संविद उज्जृंभते या ब्रह्मादि पिपीलिकांत तनुषु प्रोता जगत साक्षिणी सैवाहम न च दृश्य वस्तु इति दृढ़ प्रज्ञापि यस्यास्ति चेत् चांडालोस्तु सतु दुजोस्तु गुरुहु इति एषा मनीषा मम. That's what this shloka is. It says, see, we all go through avastatraya, jagrat, Swapna and Sushupti. In Jagrat, we are, you know, awake. So we seem to claim everything. I am doing it, I am doing that, I am busy, I am all that. In Swapna also, we seem to claim. Because there, somewhere you woke up and said, I saw a dream. So you attach your eye to it. Swapna. In Sushupti, I don't know what you can claim, but you have so much audacity. We all have that much audacity to get up from Sushupti and say in past tense, I had a good sleep. Your indriyas were not working. Your buddhi was not working. Your body was a jada. Your entire manas and indriyas are switched off. You were actually dull and dead. But you got up and said, I thoroughly enjoyed the sleep. I don't know who is this I you are talking. That I is the divinity. You are not aware of anything. because modern science should actually dismiss it. Modern science says if I cannot verify, I cannot do an experiment and all this, that, and so on, I will not. This is purely anubhava. It's a, each one of us have it. So you have to believe what I say, I have to believe what you say. But there is something beyond all that. There's something which is common to all these sakshi. That's what Shankaracharya says. Then he says, Brahmadi Pipilikanta Tanushu. Starting from Brahma up to the Pipilika, which is this small little ant. Everywhere in all these bodies, it is actually something is Prota Jagasakshini. There is a Jagasakshini which is radiating. I am there, I am there, I am there. There is some common God particle in all these. Saivaham, Sahayevaham, Nadrishya Vastu. I am not what you see here and there. I am not what I see on the surface. Iti Drida Prajna. If somebody has that kind of a firm belief, Shankaracharya says, he let him be a Chandala or a Dvija, doesn't matter, he is my guru. So, you know, these acharyas, these people have brought these concepts so well again and again in many of these shlokas and all these granthas. This is from some of the Upanishads also I want to just give you, because these ideas are fully there everywhere you go. Look at this Shvetaswatara Upanishad, which is after the 10 Upanishad. This is another famous Upanishad, for which also people have written commentaries and so on. Tvam stri tvam pumanasi tvam kumara utava kumari tvam jirno dandena vanchasi tvam jato bhavasi vishwato mukaha. Beautiful shloka. It says you sport yourself as a stri. Tvam stri tvam puman, you sport yourself as a male. Tvam kumara athava kumari utava kumari, you are young, basically you are sporting yourself like a young girl or a young boy. Tvam jirnaha dandena vanchasi, you sport yourself as an old man who is all, you know, with a stick, he is struggling to walk. There also you are only there. Tvam jato bhavasi vishvato mukaha, you are the face of the earth, face of this vishwa, not earth, this universe. Everywhere you are there. That is what this Upanishad mantra is saying. It is also bringing this concept so beautifully for us. This is a Purusha Sukta, starts with saying Sahasra Sirsha Purushaha Sahasraksha Sahasrapat. No, the Sahasra you should not count. Sahasra means 1,000. There are people who write commentaries like that. You know, you one who has 1,000 faces, 1,000 eyes, and you know, 1,000 legs, you will be in trouble. If you have 1,000 legs and 1,000 eyes, you should have only 500 faces, because for every face you need 2 eyes. So that is not the way. 1,000 is figurative usage. When say sahasra sirsha purushaha sahasraksha sahasrapa, that means countless, numerous, which means everywhere. You are there everywhere. That is the meaning of this Purusha Sukta Prathama mantra. Sahasra sirsha purushaha sahasraksha sahasrapat. That's what it says. Now this is there in every Upanishad. I can keep on quoting. It says in, you know, Mahanara, Vishwatas Chakshuruta Vishwato Muko Vishwato Hasta Uta Vishwatas Pat Sambahubhyam Namati Sampatatre Dhyava Prativi Janayan. This mantra is there. Mahanara in Upanishad. Vishwatas Chakshuhu Uta Vishwato Muko Vishwato Hasta Uta Vishwatas Pat. For him, the universe is his legs, the universe is his eye, you know, Muka, face, hands. What is it saying? These are the ways by which the law of conservation of divinity is brought out. You have to see the sukshma here. Our scriptures are again and again saying, it's all divinity, divinity, and divinity, nothing else.